his name, as I ought to have told you before, is really asparagus, but that's such a fuss to pronounce that we usually call him just Gus. His coat's very shabby, he's thin as a rake, and he suffers from palsy, which makes his paws shake. Yet he was in his youth quite the smartest of cats, but no longer a terror to mice or to rats, for he isn't the cat that he was in his prime, though his name was quite famous, he says, in his time. And whenever he joins his friends at their club, which takes place at the back of the neighboring pub, he loves to regale them if someone else pays with anecdotes drawn from his palmiest days. For he once was a star of the highest degree. He has acted with Irving, he's acted with Tree, and he likes to relate his success on the halls where the gallery once gave him 7 cat calls. But his grandest creation, as he loves to tell, was Firefrow Fiddle, the fiend of the
played in my time every possible part, and I used to know 70 different speeches by heart. I'd extemporize backchat, I knew how to gag, and I knew how to let the cat out of the bag. I knew how to act with my back and my tail with an hour of rehearsal. I never could fail. I'd a voice that could soften the hardest of hearts, with an eye to plead, with a character parts. I sat by the bedside of poor little Nell when the curfew was rung. Then I swung on the bell. At the pantomime season, I never fell flat, and I once understudied Dick Whittington's cat. But my grandest creation, as history will tell, was Firefrow Fiddle, the fiend of the fell.
Then if someone will give him a toothful of gin, he will tell how he once played a part in East Lynne. At a Shakespeare performance, he once walked on pat when some actor suggested the need for a cat.
I say now, these kittens, they do not get trained as we did in the days when Victoria reigned. They do not get trained in a regular troop, and they think they are smart just to jump through a hoop.
And he says, as he scratches himself with his claws,
the theater certainly is not what it was. sudden production are all very well, but none of them equal to what I hear tell. The moment of mystery when I made history as fire-throw fiddle, the field.